What's up, everybody? Playing Street Fighter V. I hope I have this done here right. Yeah. Street Fighter V. If anybody wants to join in, please do. Open to PS3 or PS4 and PC. It's a room for six. I think there's about two slots left because as soon as I had made it, some people joined in. So feel free to talk in here. Hey! It was awesome. It was really, really good. I hope you're doing really good. You're so good at making all those pictures and stuff. My buddy Brett has a really good talent for making, I don't want to say it's online art. It's more like Photoshop work. He knows how to edit photos and cut and paste and do things in a certain way so that it looks really professionally done. And he made some collages and everything for my birthday, so they were really, really good. Oh man. So we have this, this Guile's looking really good. So what's going on with you guys? Anything new? Anybody up to anything exciting? I know in America here we just got done with, Labor Day, which is mostly for us, it's a holiday for celebrating, the workforce, you know? So that gives us, if you were able to have Saturday and Sunday off, it's a nice 3-day kind of weekend. But yeah, it was a lot of fun. And you know, Houston, people are heading back to Houston and everything, trying to figure out what they're going to do about the Hurricane Harvey. And now it sounds like Florida and Cuba and Puerto Rico is going to be hit by, what is it, Tropical Storm Irma. That's it, I think. Let me see here. Irma. It is Irma. That's crazy. Hey, I saw you enter the room. Good, good. Final round. Yeah, it's exciting. Congratulations. I'm trying to see what the deal is for Canada Cup, so we'll see. That is so exciting. Good for you. That's wonderful. Do you have a name picked out? At the hospital for a good, a solid day and a half. Yeah. Ooh, Frank West, that's good. See, that light sort of in my eyes a little, huh? There we go. That's better, I think. There we go, that's a little better. Oh man, that light was like, phew, in there.
It's go time.
Yeah, you're gonna have to set it up on your cell phone or your laptop or something. Your wife might break your fingers in the process, you know. It's possible.
Vega.
I'll show you the epitome of cute.
David's Pumpkins. Or it's David S. Pumpkins. Like, smashes pumpkins, smashing pumpkins. That was a really good band.
Round one. Fight.
Far enough away. What the hell? Nice.
Round two.
You know, it's amazing because people say, they're like, oh, Alex is so easy to play against. Every time, though, I try to play against him, it's like, it seems like he's safe on everything. Everything to me. So, it's like whenever I try to throw something out, it never works. You know what I mean? Oh man, my one jury costume's kind of falling apart a little bit. I really have to fix it. Am I religious? I try to be. Yeah. Wow! She's in a rock band? She's the... Whoop! Oh, no, he left. No, now I'll never know. I'll never know what to do. Boy, there's like nobody in here tonight. This is crazy. The Inquisitor is still, he's still on the menu. What else is really on here, huh? Yeah, I know. It's like, never mind. If anybody wants to join in, please do. There's all kinds of slots. We had people in here and then they had left, so... Oh, no! Okay, good. Oh, no. You didn't pick Vega. Oh, you picked... That's because you picked Alex. Never mind.
Round one. Fight.
Crazy. Chop, right? What kind of shampoo do you use? I have right now a shampoo that I'm trying to get through before I buy these other ones that are supposed to be better. It's a shampoo for curly hair. It's very gentle. It's by a company called WeDad. So it's O-E-I-D-A-D. And I really condition a lot. And really, my hair is pretty bad. It's always pretty dry and frizzy and damaged mostly. Even though I don't use blow dryers or straighteners or anything, my hair is just pretty bad. So, so sometimes I'll use, like I said, that shampoo. Sometimes what I do is I'll put conditioner all on the ends, and then I'll mix a little bit of, oh, he's got caught there. I'll mix a little bit of baking soda and water, and actually just sort of pour it on and scrub, and then I'll rinse it out, and then I'll pour a little bit of, apple cider vinegar and water, and I'll pour that on and let it soak, and then I rinse everything out, and then I put conditioner on all of it, and it seems to be pretty good because it's more organic, you know. Yes, we are playing Street Fighter tonight. If you want to join in, I don't know if you're available to join in, but yeah, definitely do. There's all kinds of slots open. There were a bunch of people in here earlier, and then they had left.
Akuma wins.
$10 million. Alright, let's see here. Yeah, all kinds of spots here, guys. If anybody wants to join in, please do. It is an open, endless lobby. First to one character select is on. There's no private slots, so if anybody wants to join in, go right ahead. Hey, hey, how are you? You know what? This is, I don't know if you can see it. It's just, I did a couple two coats of a real cheap, like 99-cent black nail polish. I don't think this is connecting. And then I put on, let it dry. And then I put on a coat of, like I have this UV gel light and a clear base coat. So what I do is I put the base coat on and I take black glitter and rainbow glitter that's mixed, and I just sprinkle it on. And I put it on all the nails, and I put my hands in this UV machine, and I put it in there for like I put it in there for a minute or two. And then I put on a couple of coats of like a top layer that's clear. And each time you put the coat on, you put it in the machine, you let the light go on, and it cures the gel, and they say it's a gel, but it's more like almost like a plasticky kind of feeling, you know. And it's pretty neat. I mean, it'll stay, like it won't chip or crack. It'll basically stay until it grows out. Oh, you got it. Good. Let's see here. air is being goofy.
Round one. Fight.
He's playing from far away too, so that's sort of. I'm so happy when my, critical art works, because he was doing a projectile, trying to do it. What do you mean infiltration joystick? It's what do you mean it's an octo square gate? How can it be a mix between the two? Because it's either has corners or it doesn't. I don't understand what you mean. I had an octagon gate. I tried it and I found that it was too much movement. Do you know what I mean? It was just too much for, I don't know. I didn't like how much the joystick was moving. So, I got rid of it. I went back to the square.
Chun-Li.
Oh, we've got business Chun-Li going here. She's ready for class. A crown joystick? I don't know. Oh, wow, that's interesting. Yeah, I never even heard of that. It's crazy. I mean, I know those Korean joysticks are good for Tekken, but I didn't know they had, like, a mix.
Round one. Fight!
I have a feeling it's a little laggy in there. He would have been able to block all that.
Round two. Fight.
Oh.
looks good. That was crazy.
You win.
Paradise Arcade Shop. That's interesting. See, you know what? I've been so used to this arcade stick though. I've been so used to this joystick that I don't know if I changed it. It would really screw me up right now, you know? Oh, really? I did not know that. Oh, he can punish her EX ones too. See, I know we can get her, we can give her a spinning bird kick, can't we? I'll have to look that all up.
Vega,
I'll show you the epitome of truth.
Oh, the short V reversal. The one flip. A single flip.
Round one. Fight.
That's what I was going for. Yeah, all I know about many, many years ago at Focus Attack, I think it was Focus Attack, I had ordered, eight buttons. I ordered eight. It was gray buttons, like the clearish gray buttons, and a ball top, and they didn't send it because they were like, oh, you know, we were behind on orders and all this stuff. They didn't send it. Then months passed and I messaged them. I was like, hey, you know, what about these buttons and stuff? They're like, oh, you know, everything's all backed up and whatever else. And I was like, oh, okay, you know. And then I don't think they had actually sent them. This was like a long time ago. This was maybe back in 2010 or 11. And I just figured, you know what, I'm not even gonna keep bothering about it. I'm just gonna go and buy them somewhere else, and then I ended up getting them. I put them all on my TE, but then I switched everything for this the Foehammer one. 39. Paradise, yeah, I've heard Paradise is pretty good. Street Fighter tomorrow. I don't know, I might be. Sometimes it just depends on how tired I am after work, you know. If I'm not too exhausted and stuff, there's anything crazy going on, I'll be playing, you know. SoCal Regionals, I wish. Oh man. I wish. These guys have just about the same amount of life left. Smart by Fightful. Oh man, I got the chip. That's crazy.
Vega wins.
A learning experience, I hope. That'd be nice. That's nice. Usually it's just us sort of goofing around. Yeah, that was a really good match you guys had. That was very good. Alright, so Vega. It's going to be Vega versus Akuma here. Let's see what we have.
Let's do this.
I don't think I've really won yet tonight, actually. I don't think I've won one yet. All right, Vega versus Akuma. Let's see what we have here. Okay, so Kendrix has been winning the last couple of matches, so let's see if Brutal Ed is gonna get it. He's being pushed into the corner here. Kendrix gets him with the air throw and a crush counter. Ah! Was that crouching, that's a medium kick. Gets the dizzy. Oh, goodness gracious. Alright, Kendrick's styling. Alright, let's see if Brutal Ed can get some damage in here. Don't forget to get that DP going a little bit when you see that Barcelona coming in. Brutal Ed, well, he was getting near stunned, but showing some signs of life, throwing into the corner. Oh, there you go. And Akuma is out!
Vega
but
wins.
You know what, though, at the same time, I think he's playing from Brazil, so, you know, like I said, the connection's pretty tough. All right, so let's see here. Who is up? the Street Fighter gods be on your side.
Let's do this.
Okay. Kendrix is having a baby right now. Right now. He is having a baby, so that's very exciting. A Peruvian? Oh my goodness. We're bringing everybody into this now.
Fight.
Oh, we got the dancing Vega. He's moving and grooving. Alright, so starting off some major damage here with a man grab. Great anti-air there by Ninja Dagger. I love neutral jumping. Because it's really effective, you know? That's one of my favorite things to do, too. Oh, closed it out with the V-trigger.
Round two. Fight.
I think it's a jumping light punch, right? Wow, great combo there by Kendrix into his critical art. And that looks like it might be taking about almost 75% of the health away. And that is it.
Vega wins.
Oh my goodness, babe. Baby on the way, while Vega puts in the work. The grind never stops. It really doesn't. Isn't that crazy? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. A baby girl named Sophie. Sophie, the future Vega player. I don't know if she can handle the struggle. I don't know if we want to put the struggle on baby Sophie. Maybe we should just graduate her to the level of, like, Laura. Laura, Cammy, Karen. Ooh! I don't know if anybody's ready for the Vega grind.
Let's do this.
I'll show you the epitome of beauty.
All right, let's do this. Guile versus Vega.
Round one. Fight.
Damn, the cover is quick, huh?
Round two. Fight.
Oh, that was good. Today. New daddy. Good luck, good luck, good luck. Alright, if anybody wants to join the room, please do. There are three slots that are open here. Handkerchief like that. Where? What is that? Why don't I have that color option? Paralegal studies. Well, there's two different meanings for it. One is supposedly the word Kujo over in Japan means destruction. And then there's also the book that Stephen King wrote, which is basically a dog that, you know, goes around and kind of terrorizes everybody. So either way, it pretty much means like, you know, kind of like aggressive, I guess. What did I do on Labor Day? I had met up with a friend of mine technically I guess it's Labor Day weekend. I met up with a friend of mine to go get something to eat. Man, that was really good. Really good by Ninja Dagger.
Final round. Fight.
But, yeah, but it was good times. The weather here has been very odd because of all of the rain in Texas. A lot of it had moved up the East Coast. And we were getting some pretty crazy storms here lately. Oh man. Nice Sonic Boom, the critical art. I thought he was gonna do a flash kick there real quick, but Dashjin did the throw. So the weather was sort of iffy, and that's like last night. It rained big time. And sometimes that's also a reason when I don't stream. If I'm too tired or whatever, I don't stream. But if the weather here is real stormy, I don't have good internet, so I just, you know, I don't even risk it because it's the connection's so bad. If you guys have any friends that you want to invite in the room, you know, do it. Oh, here we go. There's somebody. There's an Ed player. That's even better. Haven't seen too many Eds lately. How it is. She's fun. I wish I knew how to play her better, but I think she's interesting. The internet I actually have is Fios. I have it actually corded into my computer. It's not wireless. But I've always noticed, like I said, if it's raining real hard or whatever. Curious to see. Here, throw them real quick. Just one. Because I want to see if her... It reflects. It reflects back. That is crazy. I was wondering about... Because I know if you throw the ball out, then she can... She'll reflect all of them, right? I like her too. I think she's pretty cool. I can't wait to see what some of the guys that are really good, like the real technical guys are going to do with her. It's going to be interesting to see, definitely. Ooh, we got a whole bunch of people in here. Oh, man. Oh, Ray is playing Minot. All right, let's see. Let's see what we have.
Let's do this.
You probably, yeah, if you want to do mirror matches with her, that sounds good. Because at the same time, we can both sort of learn, you know, what she's doing at the same time. And I think she's really good for people that like zoning and things like that. But I was testing too at that one point. I tried dashing in towards you. Man, she's slow. She is just very slow. But she's got some great range, so we'll just have to see. Pretty much, I bet pretty much everybody is probably playing Minot right now, yeah. Alright, speaking about range. Vega versus Dalsum, what do we have here? Yoga Float, Yoga Drill, Yoga Teleport, Yoga Gale, Yoga Yoga Yoga.
I am not very fond of conflict. Round one.
All right, fight. So. Vega's trying to get in Barcelona. Fight is teleporting out. Oh, it's a crush counter. Vega's up slice is a great anti-air. Anti-jump in. Vega getting caught by that fire carpet. Fire rug, I guess, right? Speed trigger. Fightful having basically one hit left before he loses the round and gets a roundhouse. Right?
My beauty is unshakable.
The face. What is my day job? I can't say exactly what I do, but right, I went to school and I'm trained to do prosthetics, but there aren't any prosthetic jobs right now because of all the crazy changes and everything with the medical field and stuff for my area in insurance. The pay has gone down and it's been a bit of a pain. So, I found a job near me that does work with basically roundabout licenses. Okay, so I can't give too many specifics about it, but there's a big portion of the day where I work with people's driver's licenses and things like that, and it's interesting. I mean, it's crazy. It's a crazy job. We only have one more character left for this season. I'm hoping in season 3 they would include more classic characters. Well, I'm just trying to think of all the characters that they had released for this season. They released Abigail, they released Minot. Who else is new? Let's see real quick. Oh, they released Ed. Now, I think what they had initially said when the season had started, season 2, that they wanted to release more new characters because it's a new game, right? So, but yeah, I'm hoping that in season 3 they're going to release some, you know, classic characters too. At the time, I was really hoping for Rose, but you know now that Minot's in the game, Rose is not going to be an option. Who else? I hope that Makoto can make it in the game. I really like Makoto a lot. But yeah, you know, classic characters that aren't in the game. Sagat, Honda, Blanca. They are not in the game. You know, some characters that they make reference to that are also not in the game is Sakura, Sea Viper. There's Fei Long things in the background of one of the stages. Boy, Ninja Dagger is doing a really good job here with her. Sagat's coming back, and I mean, to me it would make some sense if they did, because then you would have the original bosses from the classic game in this one. So that would be Bison, Sagat, Balrog, and Vega again, which would be nice, you know? Yeah, some Sagat closure, right? We need some vanilla Sagat again. All right, this may be a mirror match here, possibly. We're just gonna have to see. I don't have any specific notes written up for her yet, so I don't know, like, the name of her moves. Except maybe throwing the crystal ball. We're gonna throw the crystal ball. Oh my goodness, have Sagat make peace with Ryu. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. They're making him like a good guy, which, you know, that's fine, I guess. But what's sort of making me a little crazy is how, they're kind of making Vega even waver a little in what he's doing. And I don't know. I would rather see him
this is the path of my
break
destiny.
Off and just sort of be obsessed with himself on his own than sort of feel empathy for people. You know what I mean? I just, because to me that's, I don't know. I'd rather him stay, like, true to being a narcissist and everything, but have him start feeling for Cammy and her sister and all that nonsense. I'm like, you know what? Isn't she just, like, a soldier to have, you know, have you do your dirty work and stuff? And just, you know, don't, in my opinion, don't care about them, you know? But, I don't know. They're having him feel sad for them, so whatever. Yes, Sagat killed Dan's dad. So, there is a drawing, like, one of the, what is it, original Sagat drawings? Of him standing and he's holding, his arms are down, and he's holding this man's head, and the guy's lying down on the ground. And that's supposed to be Dan's father. I don't know if I have that picture. If I can find it online. Hmm. connected. Whoop, that's it.
Final round. Fight. Hadouken!
Actually, huh, that was weird. I wonder why that happened. Let's try this again. Okay, so it's actually shit. Of course I clicked on it and it didn't. That's it right there. Isn't that crazy? So that picture was actually drawn a long, long time ago. And they already had the idea of what the story for him was gonna be even back then. 7'4". A tall, tall guy.
Round one. Fight.
Dead end. Both of these guys are catching each other in the air with their EX Barcelonas. I remember, that's something that I definitely used to do all the time in Street Fighter 4. Oh, don't have a claw to put on.
KO. Vega wins.
Okay.
It's
all right, my turn. Nope. Rifle. Okay, there we go. I didn't even know I was updating Tekken right now. What the heck is going on here? Oh, you've always been playing Street Fighter 4? Hujo Dojo, that's a good one. That's a good name. That dive forward that she does. What button is that? It's a kick, but it's not. I can't figure it out. Be doing it right. Huh. I don't know. Oh, because I'm thinking. Yeah, I don't know. That's weird. Okay, yeah, let's just play. I'm gonna have to look it up because I don't know. Directional. Oh, that went right over his head, huh? Yeah, I'm gonna have to see what her actual combos and moves are, because she seems like she's pretty fun.
It's go time.
Oh man, I know that, yeah. I know what you're talking about.
I see your future. Wanna know who will win?
Menard.
I see your future. Wanna know who will win?
Hillside Plaza. Bananas for everyone.
Round one. Fight!
God, it's like Hail Mary. Please let this work.
Final round. Fight.
Come on! Nice. That's gonna do it. It's probably gonna be it. Wow, that has so much range to it. I can't even believe. That's sort of deceiving, because I keep thinking when she does that, that it's that crystal that's gonna hit me. And then she does the throw. Then she pulls Jean and does the throw. That's crazy. Supposedly, Sian's using her a little bit, but I don't know for sure. Herbert, let's take a look. That douchebag Frankenstein brought me back. Oh my goodness, that poor guy. That's pretty cool. No, that's new for me. Colleen's another new character. Alright, so let's think about this for a second. It's Colleen, Ed, Abigail, and Minot are all the characters, and they are all, yeah, new. So hopefully season 3 will be some classic characters will be introduced. Hey, hey!
Have you considered your destiny? Do you believe in fate?
Yeah, we're checking out, to see how Minot plays a little bit.
It's so nice to meet
you. Round one. Fight!
Colleen having a hard time in the corner here. Tries to use her V trigger, Diamond Dust, to get out. Freezes Minot. Only a couple more hits for her to get. I was gonna say stun, but we got out. Boy, that's interesting. Looks like she has a super jump or something. Okay, Ray's starting to get something going again here. Colleen doing a lot of her vanity dash. It's like a man dash. Throws Minot into the corner.
There you go.
And does her. Well, it looked like that's the EX Hailstorm into a throw. Man dash is back. Throws out some. Hail rolls, hail storms. Into the Honda hand slap. What is that? That's the, is that not the fairy? That's not it. That's the vanity dash into, a button. Like a cancel into a button there. Oh, got a little bit of lag going, huh? Alright. Colleen closes it out.
Colleen wins.
Boy, she was really dealing the damage there for a minute, huh? Zeku. Oh man, playing my Elvira costume. That'd take forever. It'd take me forever just to paint that all back up again. I did do that once. One time I streamed with it on. I think it was about a year ago. I think it was for Halloween, actually, last year at Halloween time. I streamed with it on. For fun, you know? Zeku! Yeah, when I went to Evo, I knew that they had an Elvira slot machine, so I brought an Elvira get up out there and I dressed up as her, and my buddy took some pictures of me being Elvira. One of them I put out on Twitter. I'll probably put out the other ones, like, you know, off and on, just spread them out and make them fun. But yeah, it was a lot of fun. But the only thing is that it takes so much time to paint everything all up and everything. But on YouTube, I have the stream where I was dressed up as her saved. Yeah.
Wanna see my kung fu? I'll show you.
Round one.
All right, well, this is gonna be a first for me to see. It's gonna be Chun-Li versus Abigail. Chun-Li having a tough time getting something started here. Abigail keeping her in the corner. She's forcing her way out. Some DX legs. What is that move called? Is that at what is that? Charge, drop back. I don't know what that move is specifically. You know, the one where he stomps, he smashes the ground. Let's look that up. Alright, doing Abigail command grab there. Chun-Li taking on quite a bit of damage and stun, but it just went down. Abigail smash is not enough range for Chun-Li's slide. Has some armor there on that, what? I don't know what the hell that move is called. That one where he runs and then he does a flip kick. It's like a command dash, but the flip kick is,
final round.
I don't know what the specific name for that is. Chun-Li drops the combo, gets a command grab, EX bird kick in the corner. Crush counter into the, I'm just gonna say machine gun blow.
Abigail, because
that's what it looks like. But they call it a Abigail punch. But it looks just like the machine gun blow, so guess what? We're calling it the machine gun blow.
It's go time.
All right, my turn.
Let's do this.
Show you the epitome of beauty.
Dawson.
Alright, Vega vs. Dawson. Yoga everything. Everything is yoga.
Round one. Fight.
Ooh. Wow, I missed him there. Got him with the slice. I got caught by the yoga gale. Oh, I got lucky there. I did the shimmy into McMahon grab.
My beauty is unshakable.
Oh, okay.
Round two. Fight.
Okay, yoga teleport from behind. Oh! Now I got hit by a fireball twice. Block the fireball and I thought I was gonna block the trick card there. I got thrown out of my command grab. Did not work the second time.
Final round.
No.
Fight.
Trying to work him into the corner. Drop the combo. Miss the roll. Nonsense, no. From 8 till 105. I don't even know. Maybe. I'm gonna give myself like a 99. Yeah. I think I'll give myself a 99. Oh, so now the Inquisitor decides to show up. Now, right when I'm getting ready to shut it down, he's like, I think I'm gonna show up now. But.
Let's do this.
I'm gonna have to say maybe a 99. So not quite 105 or 104, but I'm getting there. I'm getting there. Just because, I know this is gonna sound weird, but my favorite weather is when it's overcast, it's green, and it's a little cool. So for me, it's spring when it's not raining too much and it's, the trees are already basically full of leaves, or right around now in the fall, before the leaves start to all change colors and turn orange and red and stuff. Because whenever I start seeing the leaves changing color, I think, oh man, you know, it's pretty, but that means winter is going to be coming and You know, you're going to have to deal with the snow and the ice and everything else, which I don't mind so much either, but sometimes it's sort of a pain when you always have to dig your car out or, you know, worry about heating it up and things like that. Oh, 75 is really good. I like anything from 65 to 75 is perfect. Anything higher than 80, I start having a tough time. And once you start getting past 85 with me, I hate it. I just can't stand it at all. Yeah. Oh my god, another tornado? How many damn tornadoes are there? There was a tornado here like a couple weeks ago, though. Let me take a look. Tornado in Pittsburgh. You guys will see me out there with my bicycle.
Round one.
Yeah, we had a tornado warning like May, around the beginning of May. Instant suntan. Even when I even think about going outside and it's sunny, my eyes just start hurting. Ray is putting in work here. Work with Ibuki. I don't know what move he was trying to complete with that EX something, but it got snuffed out. Must not be invincible on startup. Fightful move, good with this side moves. Ibuki trying to work away at the corner. Fightful throws out a critical art and it does not connect. So Jen gets his full complete combo going there against Fightful and only gets, well, I was going to say chip, but we can't chip in this game unless you have full critical art bar. So hits him with what was that, like a crouching light? I'm trying. The problem is getting all these names. I have all the specific names of everything, and it's not hard when it comes to the characters that we're used to, but some of the other ones, it's like pulling teeth. Oh my god. And Fightful leaves the stadium. Fightful is out. Guile is gone. Good games. It was good seeing you. Alright, so who are we going to see? Are we going to see Ibuki? Are we going to see Minot? Ooh, it is. It's in a real nice costume there on Ibuki. I like that a lot. She looks really pretty. So we have, I guess we would say that's more traditional garb Ibuki versus Ed, who looks like Eminem. Eminem Ed. Alright, let's see who Ed is here. Oh. Ed trying to get his Psycho Rising. That's his up kick, is Psycho Rising. Man, Ed already down, 3/4 of life, getting stunned. Luke going in with the crazy ass man dash mix ups that she does. Psycho uppers out of the corner. And activates his Psycho Cannon. A little too late.
Round two.
Metal figured out. Like how he figured out how to get that fabulous tan. Alright, Buki being aggressive with this kunais. Moves in on Ed. Watch this EX site go upper. It's the... What is that? That's a, That combo is a, target combo, for target combo. Oh my god, Taylor Swift has entered the room. Taylor Swift enters the room again, and I'm trying to shut the room down. No. Just so you know, the last time we were on, Taylor Swift was in here. She's very good. She's very good. Mom's Spaghetti! Oh my god, that is freaking, I gotta write that down. That is really good. That is really good. You're a genius. You're a genius for that. Oh my god. Oh my god, that's hilarious. That is hilarious. Okay, Inquisitor. Inquisitor, it will be possibly Guile versus Minot or Ibuki. Let's take a look here. Mom's Spaghetti. That is awesome. I'm gonna have to try to figure out what the actual name for this new set of costumes is, because I know Karen has a really nice one out in that package of costumes.
Round
also.
One. Fight.
All right, both of these guys are going in right away. Movie game works to the corner. Inquisitor. Keeping her just out of reach. EX splash kick. And he gets stunned. Nice 5-hit combo there by the Inquisitor.
Round two.
Both have one EX bar. Got the air throw. Got the cross up on Buki, building up some stun here. Okay. Inquisitor getting out of the pressure with a V reversal. Slowly chipping away at Buki's life. Oh man. Got that jump in with the flash kick.
Guile wins.
Alright, solid win by the Inquisitor. And Ibuki in her fancy dress is out. Take that and get it professionally dry cleaned.
Alright, my turn.
We need a Minot background. Something really cool in 3D, like with a beautiful purple and pink sky with the sun setting in the background in there. Pyramids, you know, and Sphinx and pharaohs and all kinds of really neat, you know, really neat stuff. Falcons maybe flying around, cool stuff, you know? I hope they do something like that. All right.
Round one. Fight.
Oh, I thought he was gonna flash kick. I was trying to block. Damn, I tried a crouch light kick there. Worry about it, because it's, you know, you figure it's on my own, so. Either land like just short of being in front of it or behind it, and then, you know, and then hope that you get him in enough time before his recovery kicks in to get him. Did I try to EX roll through that? I missed it. No, Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift, avenge me. Yeah, he is. He's very good. He's a very good guile. Alright, so this is probably going to be Guile versus Karen, which would be interesting if possibly we have the other just released Karen costume, but I don't know. I don't know. We're going to see. We're going to see what Taylor's got going on there. She's definitely one of the characters where the names for her moves are crazy. So I have to come up with generic names for her moves because I can't even pronounce half of them. Seriously, I'm not wrong. Okay. Alright, Karen getting things started with a slide. Throws the guy into the center of the screen. Gets a free jump in and follows it up with the Rekka. And... well, no, that's not a Rekka. That's a command dash into a, what is that? I guess that's one of the... upward. It's not necessarily a DP, it's like an upward movement. Okay, she has to figure out a way to get through these projectiles here. Victor hits her with the air throw, tries to get the overhead. Ends up getting the EX flash kick. So you could sort of see when he got his V-trigger going, he threw out a couple sonic booms to try to get her to stand blocking, and then he went in with the overhead, but ended up missing that overhead a little bit there. Alright, Karen tries to get her V-reversal going, does a slide, works, dial into the corner, got flash kicks out. Karen trying to get something going, applying some pressure there, getting knocked out by the projectiles, so she throws him back in the corner. And she activates her V-trigger, and gets chipped out by Inquisitor's Sonic Hurricane.
Guile wins.
Critical art. Yes. Hey, definitely. Definitely. You know what? I try to stream Tekken on the weekends. So, so just if you want to play, feel free. Feel free to join the room. And then, but it's usually on the PS4. I don't have it on PC, just so you know. But yeah, feel free to join in the rooms and it'll be good. And then after we play Tekken, I usually put some Street Fighter on too. Ed. Mom's Spaghetti. Oh my god. That is the best. That is the best name ever. Alright, so we got a tan Mom Spaghetti going against Crocodile. It looks like he's even in a light pink color. Maybe that's a pastel. Alright, Psycho Leopard tries to work his way in. Both of these guys are still in the center of the screen. EX Sonic Boom. Not holding Ed back, still being very aggressive. Using his what is that? That's a psycho shot. That projectile that he throws out. Activates his psycho cannon. And is trying to use his machine gun blow, which does do some chip damage on him. But not enough to win the round. Okay, uses his V skill to try to pull Guile in. Does he throw? Does some good damage there. The combo. That must be his, Okay, both of these guys have this about the same amount of life, but Twister has just activated his feature more. Ed just used his reversal to try to get in and got caught. Caught in the barrage of Psycho. Not Psycho. Sonic projectiles. I'm tired, guys. I worked all day today. But I'm trying to go over all my notes for this stuff. Oh, my lord.
It's go time.
I am probably going to shut it down, guys, because I'm really tired. I'm sorry. I gotta go to bed. I only have Tekken on the PS4, and I didn't know that everybody was going to be using it on the PC. Damn it. I wish Tekken had the capability that we do with this, where we can play on PC and on the PS4, and I can play against everybody. I didn't know that it's only that people mainly played on the PC now, but sad panda. No. That was a lot of fun. Good games. To everybody that joined the room, thank you so much for coming in tonight. Our Vega buddy, Kendricks, is having a baby right now. I hope everything goes great and smoothly and everything works out for his family. And I hope you guys had a really good time. And the next time I will stream, I'll put it out on Twitter. It may be tomorrow night, I'm not quite sure, but if you're free, join in the lobby, talk on the chat, whatever you want to do, and we will see you next time. Bye.